And we are back here live at Baswell Field on the campus of Arkansas Tech University, where the Wonder Boys are trying to break out the brooms against the East Central Oklahoma Tigers. The Wonder Boys have taken the first two games via the run rule, 11-1 Friday night and 12-2 just moments ago. So here in game three, they're going for the sweep. Wonder Boys coming into this game three with a record of 27-13, 18-8 in GAC play, while East Central Oklahoma falls to 8-33 on the year and 5-21 in GAC play. Jack Rector toes the bump for the Wonder Boys, and he'll be set to face Deion Allen, Christian Whitaker, and Nick Blankenship for the Tigers here in the top of the first inning. Beautiful, beautiful day here at the ballpark. Been a very nice crowd here. Folks have really enjoyed themselves. And the lefty for the Wonder Boys is ready to go. Rector's first pitch is swung on and missed. Strike one. Rector out of Peoria, Arizona, getting the start for the Wonder Boys here today. And here comes the lefty's 0-1. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Rector comes into today with a 4.42 ERA with four wins, three losses. This would be his 11th appearance. His 0-2 off the plate, but Allen almost swung at that, but as it stands, one ball, two strikes. Rector's gone 38 and two-thirds innings, giving up 34 hits, 22 runs, 19 of those earned. He struck out 42 batters. That pitch comes inside. Almost hits Allen as he ducks out of the way. And that evens the count at two balls, two strikes. And here comes Rector's 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. And that's how we begin the game three here. Rector strikes out Allen. And that'll bring up Christian Whitaker, the Tigers' first baseman.
First baseman, number 27, Christian Whitaker.
Again, Rector out of Peoria, Arizona, from Concordia University in Chicago. The roads that baseball players take sometimes get windy and include many stops. Here's the lefty's pitch. That's off the plate for a ball. One ball, no strikes. And here comes the 1-0. Inside corner for a strike. One ball, one strike. The Wonder Boys will line up Poe, Grant Jones, and Rinaldo in the outfield from left to right. Here comes the pitch. In there for a called strike. One ball, two strikes now. And the Wonder Boys will have Bard over at third, Cole Dawson at short, Marcos Cabranes at second, and Schwenke over at first. And here comes Rector's 1-2. That is grounded right at Cabranes at second, fields it clean, flips to first, and there's two away now in the bottom of the first inning here. 4-3 on the putout. And your battery today, Jack Rector on the mound and Christian Olea behind the plate. So with two away now, that'll bring up Nick Blankenship for the Tigers. Blankenship over at shortstop today. And here's Rector's pitch. Fouled straight back. Strike one. Wonder Boys are tied atop the standings now at 18-8 in the GAC. What a season Coach Dawson's men have put together here. Here's the 0-1. Grounded foul down the third baseline. No balls, two strikes now. Again, you could not ask for a better day at the ballpark. Beautiful weather. Great baseball being played. Just doesn't get any better. Here's Rector's 0-2. That's down. Skips away from Olea. One ball, two strikes. Here's the lefty's 0-2. That is hit pretty well into center, but coming on is Grant Jones. He's there to make the play, and that'll do it for the Tigers here in the top of the first. As we head to the bottom of the first inning, there's no score.
Liberty Central on the top of the first. They show no runs and no hits. There's no runners left on base.
We're back here at beautiful Baswell Field as we head to the bottom of the first here in game number three of this GAC series between the Wonder Boys and the Tigers of East Central Oklahoma. Wonder Boys have run ruled the Tigers in the first two games. As we get started here in the bottom of the first in game number three, the Wonder Boys are going to send Marcos Cabranes, Grant Jones, and Logan Schwenke to the plate to face Clayton Solomon. Solomon, the right-hander, has a record today of 0-6. Comes into today with a 12.79 ERA. This will be his 10th appearance and his 7th start. He's gone 31 and two-thirds innings. He's given up 53 hits. 52 runs, 45 of those were earned. 25 walks, 15 strikeouts. And opponents are hitting 3.79 against. The Wonder Boys will try to get things started here. Again, it'll be Cabranes, Grant Jones, Logan Schwenke. The first three for the Wonder Boys here. And we're about ready to go here. Cabranes steps in. And Solomon's ready to go. And the righty's first pitch. That's high for a ball. Righty's checking his wristband there. And his next pitch to Cabranes is hit high and pretty deep to left field. Back to the wall and gone. Get up, get back, and get out. Marcos Cabranes has put the Wonder Boys on top right off the bat here in the bottom of the first. He crushed that one to deep left field. As Cabranes crosses home plate, it is 1-0 Wonder Boys. Marcos did not miss that one for his 6th home run of the year. And that'll bring up Grant Jones now. And the first pitch to Jones is down for a ball. Marco Cabranes puts the Wonder Boys on top 1-0. And we are off and running here, folks, at the Baz. Here's the pitch. That's downstairs. Two balls, no strikes. Getting a sweep in baseball is so hard to do. So if you're a Wonder Boy, you sure do like to see that. Jumping out on top here in game three. And pitch to Jones, swung on and missed. Two balls, one strike now. To the junior out of Little Rock and Seminole State College. Here's the 2-1. That's off the plate. Three balls, one strike. Solomon's 3-1, and that's a walk. So Grant Jones is aboard now. And Logan Schwenke makes his way to the plate. Nobody out. The first two batters of the game have reached here for the Wonder Boys. Cabranes with the massive blast to left field. Grant Jones with a walk. And now Logan Schwenke. And Solomon throws to first. Jones is back standing up. And the pitch to Schwenke, down for a ball, ball one. Schwenke, the redshirt senior out of Chandler, Arizona, and Perry High School. Here comes Solomon's 1-0 pitch, checks the runner, comes home. That's in there for a called strike on the outside edge. One ball, one strike now to the Tech first baseman. Schwenke hitting 342 on the season. And throw over to first, but the runner's back. Schwenke has 7 home runs on the season, 40 base hits. And here's the pitch. That's inside, and it hit him. Just got a piece of Schwenke. So he'll trot down to first. And now there's runners at first and second, but still nobody out here in the bottom of the first. And Nick Jones, the Tech designated hitter, makes his way to the plate to take his turn. Facing Clayton Solomon. Nobody out. Already one run across here for the Wonder Boys. And a chance for more. Here's Solomon's pitch. That's high. Ball one. Nick Jones hit a home run in the first inning of game number 2 today, or the first game today. Here's the 1-0. That catches the outside corner. One ball, one strike. And the 1-1 from Solomon. That was a little too far outside, says Mr. Home Plate umpire. Two balls, one strike. Another great crowd here at Baswell Field, enjoying themselves today. The Wonder Boys are trying to sweep. Here's the 2-1. That's high, ball three. Three balls, one strike to Nick Jones. Nobody out, runners on first and second. And the righty Solomon's ready. Here's the pitch. That is popped up foul and out of play over the third base side. Three balls, two strikes. Here's the 3-1. That bounced well short of home plate. And so the bases are full of Wonder Boys now with nobody out here in the bottom of the first. And Christian Olea strolling to the plate. Boatman, the Tiger catcher, has made a little visit to the mound to kind of check on his hurler. So the first four batters of the game have all reached here against Clayton Solomon. Marcos Cabranes led off with a massive blast to left field. And since then, there have been two walks and a hit by pitch. And that loads them up for Christian Olea. Olea, the Wonder Boy catcher, comes into this game hitting 294. He's got three home runs on the year. And Solomon's pitch in there for a called strike. Big spot here early for the Wonder Boys. A chance to do some early damage. Here's the 0-1. Swung on and missed, and Olea's in the hole now. No balls, two strikes. Remember, baseball fans, the third game of these GAC series are only seven innings. So jumping out here would be big. Swing and a miss. Olea goes down on strikes for the first out of the inning. Olea goes down on three pitches, and that'll bring up Keaton Rinaldo. Rinaldo leads the team in average and hits. And his first pitch he sees from Solomon is downstairs. He also has eight home runs on the year. Big spot here. Bases loaded, one out. Foul back out of play. And Rinaldo will hit with a 1-1 count. Pitches in there for a strike. One ball, two strikes now. Here's the 1-2. That's down and away. Nice stop by the catcher there to keep that from getting by. Two balls, two strikes now. To the Tech right fielder. Here's Solomon's 2-2. That's high. Gets away from the catcher. Scrambling home to score is Grant Jones, and it's now 2-0, Wonder Boys. Schwenke moves up to third. Pick Jones over to second. So now there's one out. A 3-2 count now on Keaton Rinaldo, and runners on second and third. 2-0 Wonder Boys here in the bottom of the first. Here's the pitch. Downstairs, ball four, and once again the bases are loaded. That's the third walk of the inning. Still only been one ball put into play so far. Wonder Boys lead it 2-0. Brendan Bard makes his way to the plate. Brendan Bard plays a mean third base for the Wonder Boys. He bats here, the bases loaded and one out. Here's the pitch. In there for a called strike. Brendan Bard out of Kansas City, Kansas. Waits on the 0-1. That catches the outside corner, strike two. No balls, two strikes. Shane Poe waits on deck for the Wonder Boys. Here's the 0-2. That is line into left field, sinking for a base hit. Schwenke had to hold up to see if that would drop. So everybody moves up. Schwenke scores. It's now 3-0. Wonder Boys, and the bases still are loaded. Bard hit that pretty hard. The left fielder, Allen, was coming in as that ball was sinking, so Schwenke kind of had to hold up to see if that was going to drop, but he does score, and it's 3-0 now. And Shane Poe makes his way to the plate. And the bases are still full of Wonder Boys. Here's the pitch. That ball is lifted in the air to left center field. Drifting back is Allen, and coming over to make the catch is Sperry. Tagging to score is Jones. And it is now 4-0, Wonder Boys. On the sacrifice fly from Shane Poe. And there's still runners at second and third, but now there's two outs for Mr. Cole Dawson. The kid from right here in Russellville, Arkansas. Here's the pitch. Miss for a ball. 4-0, Wonder Boys here in the bottom of the first. Four runs on just two base hits. Three walks and a hit by pitch will help that number. Here's the pitch. In there for a called strike. And that hits him. So once again, the bases are loaded. And that brings us right back to the top of the order. The Wonder Boys have batted around here in the first inning. Marcos Cabranes, who started this party off with a towering home run to left field, bats here now with the bases loaded and two outs. Three walks, two hit by pitch. And the bases are full again. And the first pitch to Cabranes misses for a ball. Tech comes in right off the bat in the bottom of the first, puts up crooked numbers. That's exactly what you like to see. Here's the pitch. Foul back up over the press box here. One ball, one strike. Marcos Cabranes out of Bayamon, Puerto Rico. And a pitch to him's in there for a strike. One ball, two strikes now. Bayamon, Puerto Rico via North Arc Community College. Again, baseball players take some windy roads to get where they're going. Here's the 1-2, and that hits him, and that'll bring home another run. So it's now 5-0, Wonder Boys, and that'll bring up Grant Jones. Jones walked in his first at bat here in the first inning. And the bases are still loaded. And the first pitch to Jones misses for a ball. 5-0, Wonder Boys on just two hits. One of those was a solo home run. Here's the pitch. Grounded sharply to first base. Fielded nicely there by Whitaker, who flips to Solomon. And that'll be it for the Wonder Boys in the bottom of the first. But on just two base hits, the Wonder Boys push across five runs. And as we head to the second inning here in the final game of this series, the Wonder Boys lead the Tigers 5-0.
Thank you.
And we're back here to Baswell Field where the Wonder Boys pounce for five runs in the bottom of the first. And as we play here in the second inning, they lead East Central Oklahoma 5-0. Jack Rector back to the mound for the Wonder Boys. He set the Tigers down in order in the first. He'll face Price Jackson here to begin the second. And the lefty's first pitch. Swing and a miss. If you're Coach Dawson, this is what you want to see when you're going for the sweep. You jump right out on top. 5-0 in the first inning. That pitch misses for a ball. And again, these third games in these series are only 7 innings, so definitely like to see that. Here's the 1-1 from Rector. Fouled back. Two strikes now. That bounced off the net and wound up back in front of home plate. Don't see that very often. So the count's 1-2 now. And here's the 1-2. That is lifted into right field, drifting foul. And the count will stay 1-2. Ball, 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. Grounded over to third. Fielded by Bard. Over to first to Swanky in time. And Price Jackson goes down 5-3 to begin the second inning here. Boys, let me just tell you, Brendan Bard plays a smooth third base. He ranged to his left. Fielded that clean. Came up nice and smooth through to first in plenty of time. He is a joy to watch over there at the hot corner. That'll bring up Austin Wood now. Austin Wood DHing for the Tigers today. And Rector's first pitch to him, fouled straight back. Five to nothing, Wonder Boys. Here's Rector's pitch. That is lifted softly into right field and will drop for a base hit. So Austin Wood is aboard with a one-out single here. Didn't hit that just particularly hard, but just sunk down in between the second baseman Cabranes and the right fielder Ranallo for a one-out hit. And that'll bring up Tanner Collins now. Collins playing second baseman today for the Tigers. Tech sets up for the double play here. And here's Rector's pitch. Grounded right at Dawson. Could be two. Flips to Cabranes for one. On to Schwenke to complete the 6-4-3 twin killing. And just like that, the top of the second is over. Nicely done there by the Wonder Boys. As we head to the bottom of the second inning, it is 5-0 Tech.
Thank you.
right, we're back here at Baswell Field for the bottom of the second. And the Wonder Boys, after sending 11 men to the plate with only two base hits in the first inning, we'll send Logan Schwenke, Nick Jones, and Christian Olea to the plate here in the bottom of the second with a 5-0 lead. Clayton Solomon's first pitch to Schwenke misses for a ball. Schwenke was hit by a pitch in the first. Here's the 1-0 from Solomon. That's fouled over the first base side and out of play. One ball, one strike now on the Tech first baseman. Five to nothing, Wonder Boys. Here's the pitch. That missed. Two balls, one strike. And the 2-1 from Solomon. That's downstairs. Ball three. Three balls, one strike. Comes the 3-1 to Schwenke. That's in there for a called strike. The count runs full now. Full count on the Tech first baseman. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Schwenke's down on strikes for the first out of the inning. And that'll bring up Nick Jones now. Jones in his familiar DH role for the Wonder Boys. Jones walked back in the first. Here's the pitch. That's downstairs for a ball. One ball, no strikes. 5-0 Wonder Boys as we play here in the bottom of the second. Pitch, that's hammered into right center field. That's going to get down and get all the way to the wall. It caroms off the wall. Jones is already at second base, standing up with a double. Nick Jones. He hit that ball hard. It split the gap, bounced off the wall, and he cruised into second base with a stand-up double, and that'll bring Christian Olea to the plate with one away and Nick Jones standing over there in scoring position. How about we make it 6-0 right here, Mr. Olea? Base hit will do it. Solomon checks the runner and comes home. That gets well off the plate, bounces away from the catcher Boatman, but it bounced straight up in the air, and he was able to keep Jones over there at second. When it first bounced, I thought that was going to be a chance for Jones to advance, but Boatman was able to keep that in front of him. Here's the 1-0. In there for a called strike. One ball, one strike to the Tech catcher. Solomon checks the runner and comes home. That's down and in. Ball two, two balls, one strike. Solomon checks the runner again. Here's the 2-1. That misses. Ball three. Solomon now up to 46 pitches here with one out in the second inning. A 3-1 count on Olea. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Runs the count full. Olea struck out in the first inning. Works with a full count here and one out and a runner over in scoring position at second base. Here's the pitch. That misses down and away, so Christian Olea is aboard with a walk. And that'll bring up Keaton Rinaldo now. That's the fourth walk of the game for Solomon. To go along with three batters hit by a pitch. Seven free base runners for the Wonder Boys so far. So one out here now for Keaton Rinaldo. And the first pitch to Rinaldo missed. Nice job by the catcher Boatman there to keep that in front. Solomon is definitely struggling with command here. That's an understatement. He's missing pretty badly. Can't see down into the bullpen down the first base line here, but you can't think there's much longer for Mr. Solomon here. Solomon steps off and kind of half-heartedly spins over to second and fakes a throw. And here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss. One ball, one strike. Rinaldo also walked back in the first. And Solomon's ready with the 1-1. Here's the pitch. That ball's hit pretty well into center field. Going back is the center fielder, Sperry. That is out of here. Get up, get back, and get out. Keaton Rinaldo, a three-run blast over the wall in right center. And the Wonder Boys are up 8-0 here in the bottom of the second. Rinaldo crosses home plate. Celebrates with his teammates. The fans love it. It is 8-0. Folks, that is only the third base hit for the Wonder Boys, or fourth base hit, excuse me, for the Wonder Boys. And that's going to be it for Clayton Solomon. He gives up 8 runs in just an inning and a third. And as you've had a bad day, plays over the PA system. The Tigers are going to go to the pen. And we'll be right back to tell you who it is here in just a moment.
Your attention, please, fans. Pitching change for East Central. No, number 29, Jacob Hall.
We're back here at Baswell Field with the Wonder Boys leading 8-0 here in the bottom of the second. The Wonder Boys put up 5 in the first. They've scored 3 in the second, and they bat here with 1 away. And Brendan Bard strolling to the plate here to face Jacob Poff. Poff is a 6'3 junior out of Oklahoma City, who comes into today with an ERA of 9, one loss record of 1-0. This will be his 8th appearance. He's pitched 13 innings, given up 18 hits, 13 or 16 runs, 13 of those earned. Opponents are hitting .310 against. And he's set to face off against Brendan Bard with one away here in the bottom of the second. And your Wonder Boys already up 8-0. So the Tigers only get an inning and a third out of Solomon. And the first pitch misses badly and hits Bard. Bard's feeling that. Bard has not gone down to first yet. He's over here in the third base side, and he's in quite a bit of pain. He's trying to shake it off. Now he heads down to first. That'll now be the fourth batter of the game so far. We're in the second inning to be hit by a pitch. That'll bring up Shane Poe now. Bard looks to be okay. He's got his lead over there at first. Here's the pitch to Poe. That's high for a ball. So four walks and four hit by pitch. Here's we play in the bottom of the second. Eight free base runners for the Wonder Boys so far. That pitch is lined back up the middle for a base hit. Bard's going to round second, head to third. Poe makes his turn, but will hold at first. And the Wonder Boys have runners at the corners now for Cole Dawson. Poe hit that hard. The second baseman, Collins, made a diving attempt at it, but it got over his head and into center field. And as Cole Dawson strolls to the plate, he'll have runners at the corners with only one away here in the bottom of the second. The Wonder Boys are threatening for even more here. Ronaldo with the big shot of this inning, a three-run blast. And here's the first pitch to Dawson. That misses, ball one. Cole Dawson, the young man from right here in Russellville. Next pitch has popped up into shallow left center. The shortstop Blankenship drifts out and is there to make the catch. And Dawson's retired for the second out of the inning. That'll bring us back to the top of the order here in Marcos Cabranes. We're in the second inning. Cabranes is getting his third at bat. Cabranes has homered and been hit by a pitch. And he'll bat here with runners at the corners and two out. And pops first pitch to Cabranes in there on the inside corner for a strike. Here comes Pops 0-1. It's chopped right at the third baseman. Jackson fields it clean and throws to first in time to retire Cabranes, and that'll be it for the Wonder Boys here in the bottom of the second. But they add three more on Ronaldo's blast. And as we head to the third inning here at Baswell Field, it's Arkansas Tech 8, East Central Oklahoma 0.
Leading off the top of the third for East Central, catcher number 9, Gage Copeland.
We're back here for the top of the third inning at Baswell Field with the Wonder Boys leading 8-0. And the Tigers are going to send the bottom third of the order up here against Jack Rector. And Gage Bateman will be up first, and he takes the first Rector pitch and fouls it back for strike one. Boatman here for his first plate appearance of the day. Here's the 0-1. That's off the plate. One ball, one strike now. And the next pitch misses for a ball. Two balls, one strike. Rector's ready with the 2-1. That's off the plate. Ball three. Three balls, one strike. And the Wonder Boys have certainly made the Tigers pay for all the free bases. That's fouled back and out of play, and the count runs full now. Here comes Rector's 3-2. Swing and a miss. And that's the way we begin the third as Boatman goes down on strikes. And there's one away now. And that'll bring up Ben Tate. Tate stands in now to face Rector. And here's the first pitch. That's high and outside. One ball now. Here comes Rector's 1-0. That's fouled at the plate. One ball, one strike. Rector on here in his third inning of work. Here's the 1-1. That is line right at Bard, leaping catch. Wow, what a play over there, Mr. Brandon Bard. Tip of the cap to you, young fella. Wow. Tate absolutely smoked that ball. Bard leaped up, made the grab. And now there's two away here. And that'll bring up the number 9 hitter for the Tigers, Britton Sperry. Man, I'm telling you, Mr. Bard is a blast to watch play over there at third. And Rector's first pitch to Sperry. I got away from him a little bit. For a ball, one ball, no strikes. Eight to nothing Wonder Boys here in the top of the third. Looking for the sweep. And the 1-0 swung and missed. One ball, one strike now. Here's the 1-1. That is popped up, drifting back. Olay is going to give it a look, but that is in play, and he makes the catch right up against the net. There's a tip of the cap for you, Mr. Olay. And that's going to do it for the Tigers here in the top of the third. We head to the bottom of the third inning here at Baswell Field. It's Arkansas Tech 8, East Central Oklahoma nothing. All right, we return to play here in Russellville with the Wonder Boys leading the Tigers 8-0.
And
set to face Jacob Poff here in the bottom of the third will be Grant Jones, Logan Schwenke, and Nick Jones. Grant Jones leads us off here and takes the first pitch from Poff upstairs for a ball. One ball, no strikes. 8-0, Wonder Boys. Tech with 8 runs on 5 hits. And Poff's 1-0. That's outside. Ball 2. 2 balls, no strike. Man, that pitch there just seemed to float in. Doesn't look to be a whole lot of velocity on that pitch. It missed, so it's 2 balls, no strike here. And the righty brings it home. That's cut on and fouled straight back. 2 balls, 1 strike now. And Pop's ready with the 2-1. Here it comes. Again, just floats that in there. 3 balls, 1 strike now. Again, if Daniel would have given me TrackMan, I'd have known just how low of the velocity that is. Doesn't look like much. 3 balls, 1 strike. And that's upstairs for a walk. So Grant Jones leads off the third with a walk. And that'll bring up Logan Schwenke now.
First base, number 11, Logan Schwenke.
Schwenke stands in here. That was the 5th walk of the game for a Tiger pitcher. And Poff's first delivery to Schwenke misses for a ball. 1 ball, no strikes. And Poff stares in now, and he's ready to go with a 1-0. Here's the pitch. Grounded sharply down the third baseline there. Not much of an effort there from Coach Dawson to stop that. Casually stuck his foot out there. Work hard over there, 9. Make the play. Pop's ready with the 1-1. Here it comes. That's down and in. Jones takes off for second. That ball scooted away from Boatman, so there was going to be no throw. So the Wonder Boys have a runner in scoring position here, already up 8-0 as we play here in the bottom of the third. Poff checks his runner over at second and brings it home to 2-1. That's downstairs, ball 3. Three balls, 1 strike to the Tech first baseman, Logan Schwenke. And here comes Poff's 3-1. Swung on and fouled back. And the count goes full now. Nick Jones waits on deck for the Wonder Boys. Here's the pitch. That is fouled at the plate again. Over into the third base dugout there. Karam's off. We'll do it again with a full count. Here comes the 3-2 to Schwenke. That ball is hammered but hooked well, foul. And we'll do it once again with a full count. Nobody out here. Runner over at second with the Wonder Boys up 8-0 already. Here's the pitch. In there for a called strike three. Schwenke had tossed the bat away and was headed for first base. But instead, he's caught looking on strikes. That'll be the first out of the inning here. That'll bring Nick Jones to the plate here. Jones stands in with a walk and a double to his credit. And the first pitch misses for a ball. One ball, no strikes. Here comes the 1-0. That misses high and outside. Ball two. Two balls, no strikes. Christian Olea waiting on deck for the Wonder Boys. Here comes the 2-0. Downstairs, ball three. It's a beautiful Saturday to sweep, don't you think, Wonder Boy fans? Here comes the 3-0. That's in there for a called strike. Three balls, one strike now to Nick Jones. Just casual baseball fans just don't understand how hard it is to sweep. Anybody can beat anybody on any given day in baseball. Here comes the 3-1. That caught the outside edge for a strike. Three balls, two strikes now to Nick Jones. And that's high. So Nick Jones is aboard with a one-out walk. That'll bring up Christian Olea now. A couple of runners aboard. First and second here and one out now for Olea. Olea today has struck out and walked. Here's the pitch. That ball is hammered into left field off the third baseman's glove, and that'll get down into the corner. Racing home to score is Jones. Over to third is Nick Jones, and Christian Olea is into second with a stand-up double. He smashed that ball over the outstretched arms of the third baseman, Jackson, into the left field corner. Grant Jones cruised around to score easily. And so now with one out, that'll bring up Keaton Rinaldo. With a couple of runners in scoring position and a 9-0 Wonder Boy lead. Rinaldo, if you'll remember, last inning had that big three-run bomb that put the Wonder Boys up 8-0. He's got a chance here to score a couple more. That first pitch is up and in, brushes him back. One ball, no strikes now. On Rinaldo. Rinaldo with his 9th home run of the year last inning. Waits on the 1-0 here. Swing and a miss. Took a big cut there. One ball, one strike. Nick Jones over at third. And Olea over at second. Here comes the 1-1. In there for a called strike. One ball, two strikes. Let's go, One away here. The bottom of the third. Here's the pitch. That ball's lined into center, sinking down for a base hit. Nick Jones comes in to score. Olea moves over to third. Keaton Ranallo with the single makes it 10-0, Arkansas Tech. There's still only one out, and we've got Wonder Boys at the corners. And that'll bring up Brendan Barr. It's the seventh hit of the game for the Wonder Boys now. Wonder Boys with five in the first, three in the second, and now two here in the third, and they're threatening for more. Here's the pitch. Grounded weakly. Oh, fouled off the plate. So, folks, we're in game three here of this series. Tech scored 11 Friday night. And then 12 here in game one of the day. And 10 already. So if my Atkins, Arkansas math is right, that's 33 runs so far this series. And they've given up two. That'll get the job done. Here's the pitch. Runner goes down to second with no throw.
Yeah, baby.
So now there's runners at second and third with one out here for Mr. Bard. Yeah, 33-2 ought to get it done. I think that'll work. Again, they were threatening for more right here. Here's the pitch. Foul back. One ball, two strikes now on Brendan Bard. Shane Poe waits on deck. And here's the pitch. Bard reaches out and gets a piece of that. Stay alive. One ball, two strikes. And another thing to keep in mind, folks, that's 33 runs now in, what is that, about 17 innings so far? We're not through 17 innings yet. That'll get the job done. And the 1-2 comes home. Again, Bard gets a piece to stay alive. The Tigers pitching staff have definitely made their share of mistakes, but what you like to see here is that the Wonder Boys have made them pay. And that's what you love. One ball, two strikes. Here's the pitch. That's down. Two balls, two strikes. That's a good take there by Bard. He'd kind of been in a little bit of a swing mode, but was able to hold up there. Evens the count now at 2-2. Pops 2-2 comes home. That is popped up into shallow center. Coming in is the center fielder Sperry. Makes the catch, tagging and heading home is Olea. And it is now 11-0, Wonder Boys. So Bard with the sack fly brings home Olea. And so now there's two away here in the bottom of the third for Shane Poe. With Ranallo now over at second base. 11-0 Wonder Boys. Here's the pitch. That ball is flied into right center field. Coming over is the right fielder, Tate. He's there to make the grab. And Poe is retired to end the third inning. But the Wonder Boys add on three more. And as we head to the fourth inning here of game three of this GAC series, your Wonder Boys lead the Tigers 11-0.
We'll pitch the first chance to catch the changes for the Wonder Boys. And we're going to be in center field number 33, Brandon Bunton. And we're going to be in left field number 34, Corlin Hurley. And now at second base, number one, Shane Hall. Back behind the plate, number 39, Marcos Cabrera.
And we're back here at Baswell Field. We head to the fourth inning, the final of this three-game series here with the Wonder Boys leading the Tigers 11-0. Jack Rector back to the mound for his fourth inning of work. And he's set to face the top of the lineup here for the Tigers. Deion Allen, first pitch to him, is swung on and missed. Wonder Boys have made some changes. Brandon Bunton moves into center field. Aaron Hogue into left field. Shane Poe moves from left over to second. And the 0-1 is in there for a strike. Allen's in the hole 0-2. And Cabranes moves from second to behind the plate. So Coach Dawson up 11-0, making a few moves here. Here comes the 0-2 from Rector. It's outside, ball one. Here comes the 1-2 from Rector. Fouled straight back. The count remains 1-2. And the 1-2 from Rector. That's down and away. Ball two. Two balls, two strikes now. Pitch misses. Count runs full now. Three balls, two strikes. The Tigers leadoff hitter. It's 11-0 Wonder Boys. Here's the 3-2. Swing and a miss. Allen goes down on strikes for the second time today. And there's one away here in the top of the fourth. That's Rector's third strikeout of the day. He's through 3 1/3 so far, giving up one base hit.
First base, number 27, Christian Whitaker.
And that'll bring Christian Whitaker to the plate. Whitaker grounded out in his first at bat. And Rector's first pitch to him, fouled at the plate for a ball, or for a strike. Balls, one strike here to Christian Whitaker. And Rector comes home. Swing and a miss, strike two. Here's the 0-2. Swung on and missed. Bronis holds on, and that's a strikeout. Back-to-back strikeouts here to start the fourth. And that's the fourth strikeout of the day for Mr. Rector. And that's going to bring up Nick Blankenship now. Blankenship flied out in his first at-bat. He bats here with the bases empty and two outs and an 11-0 Wonder Boy lead. Here's Rector's pitch. Blankenship thought about that, but held off. pitch miss for a ball. And the 1-0 comes home. Downstairs, ball two. Two balls, no strikes. You just could not have asked for a better day for baseball. Here comes Rector's 2-0. That is lined into left center field, and that's down into the gap. It's going to roll to the wall, bounce off the wall. Button picks it up, fires it back in, but Blankenship is over at second base with a two-out double. And the Tigers have a man in scoring position now ahead of Price Jackson, the Tiger third baseman. Like I said, the weather's been absolutely gorgeous today, and the Wonder Boys have played along with the wonderful weather and played wonderful themselves and given the fans lots to enjoy today. Here's Rector's pitch. It's downstairs, ball one. And the lefty's ready. Here's the pitch. That's popped up into shallow right field. Rinaldo drifts over, makes the catch, and that's going to do it for the Tigers here in the top of the fourth. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning here at Baswell Field with your Wonder Boys leading East Central Oklahoma 11-0.
Attention, please, fans. Pitching change for East Central. Now, number 22, Bo Jenkins.
Back here at the Baz for the bottom of the fourth inning with your Wonder Boys up 11-0. And the Tigers are going to the pen for their third pitcher of the day. They're going to bring in the righty, Bo Driggers. Driggers is a sophomore. He's going to come on here to face Cole Dawson and then back to the top of the Wonder Boy order in Marcos Cabranes. Wonder Boys up 11-0. Wonder Boys with 11 runs on 7 hits. They get 5 in the first and then 3 in the second and the third. Jack Rector's giving up 2 runs, or 2, excuse me, 2 hits in his first 4 innings of work here. Nice job by him. So Cole Dawson will stand in here against the new Tiger pitcher, Bo Driggers. And the first pitch to Dawson misses for a ball. One ball, no strikes. Here comes the 1-0. Swung on and fouled straight back. One ball, one strike now. Looks like the Wonder Boys have got some action in the pen, so may look to go to the pen here. Can't tell who it is. Here comes the 1-1. That's in there for a called strike. One ball, two strikes now. Here comes the 1-2. That's down and away. Ball two. Two balls, two strikes. So, again, looks like Rector's day might be done. He's gone four innings. Cade four, only giving up two hits. And that pitch to Dawson is fouled back out of play over the right side. And we'll stay here at a 2-2 count. Trying to see who that is down there. Looks like JT Cafferty warming up in the pen for the Wonder Boys. And that pitch misses, and the count runs full now on Dawson. Full count here on the Tech 9-hole hitter, Cole Dawson. Here's the pitch. And that misses down and away for a leadoff walk. So Dawson's aboard here to begin the fourth. And we're back to the top of the order now for Marcos Cabranes. It's now the seventh walk of the game to go along with four hit batters. And the first pitch to Cabranes misses outside for a ball. One ball, no strikes. It's 11 free base runners. Here's the 1-0 swing and a miss. Big cut from Cabranes there. One ball, one strike now. And here comes the 1-1. That's down, ball two. Two balls, one strike. The Wonder Boys up 11-0. They've got the leadoff man aboard here in the fourth inning. Here comes the 2-1 from Driggers. That's down and in, ball three. Three balls, one strike. Driggers has the best ERA on the team. 491. Here comes the 3-1. And that hits Cabranes in the back of the helmet, I believe. Folks, that is the fifth batter to be hit by a pitch. And we're in the fourth inning. That is 12 runners on base between walks and hit by pitch. So, folks, that's pretty interesting. You don't see that very often. So that'll put Wonder Boys at first and second now for Brandon Button. Button was a defensive replacement last inning. He comes on now with runners on first and second, nobody out. And here comes the pitch. That is popped up right at the second baseman. Collins squeezes it for the first out. One pitch, one out for Mr. Button. And that'll bring up now Logan Schwenke.
First baseman, number 11, Logan Schwenke.
Schwenke has been hit by a pitch and has struck out twice. And here's the first pitch in there for a called strike. Triggers checks the runner and comes home with the 0-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. Well, Schwenke does not get cheated at the plate. He is looking to swing the bat. He's in the hole here, 0-2 now, one away. And Driggers comes home. Check swing, he went, said Mr. Home Plate umpire, and Schwenke goes down with strikes for the third time today. So now there's two outs here in the bottom of the fourth. And that'll bring up Nick Jones. Nick Jones has doubled and walked twice on the day. And the Tigers are trying to hold the Wonder Boys off the scoreboard for the first time in this game. Let's see if Nick Jones can prevent that from happening. He swings and misses at the first pitch. No balls, one strike. Here's the pitch. In there for a called strike. He's in the hole now, 0-2. Two outs here in the bottom of the fourth with an 11-0 Wonder Boy lead. That pitch misses. One ball, two strikes. Here's the pitch. That is fouled into the net over here on the third baseline. We'll stay right here with a 1-2 count. Here comes Driggers, 1-2. Inside. Two balls, two strikes. Driggers is ready with the 2-2. Foul back. Jones stays alive. Still two balls, two strikes. The Tech designated hitter. And Driggers is ready with another 2-2. And brings it home. Outside, and let's see, I believe that was only ball three. Nick Jones tossed the bat away and was headed for first base, but Mr. Home Plate umpire says don't go away, not just yet, stay here with me just a little longer. Now it's a full count. Three balls, two strikes, two outs here in the bottom of the fourth. And here's the pitch. High. Now it's ball four. Mr. Jones, you can stroll down to first base. Folks, that's going to load the bases up with Wonder Boys. Again, the Wonder Boys have scored in every inning so far. And if they're going to do it again here, it'll be up to Mr. Aaron Hoag getting his first at bat of the game here. First pitch to Hoag is in there for a called strike. Base is loaded. No balls, one strike to Aaron Hoag. Here's the pitch. Outside, ball one. One ball, one strike. Let's see if the kid from Clinton, Arkansas can come through here with a little something to grow the Wonder Boy lead. Here's the pitch. Foul back. One ball, two strikes now. A Wonder Boy at every base. Here's the pitch. Outside. Evens account. Two balls, two strikes. And the pitch is popped up on the infield. Coming on is the second baseman, Collins. He's there to make the grab. And the Wonder Boys, for the first time today, or in this game anyway, do not get on the board. As we head to the fifth inning here at Baswell Field, it's your Wonder Boys leading the Tigers 11-0.
Attention, please, fans. Pitching change for Arkansas Tech. Now on the mound, number 32, JT Cafferty.
Back here at the Baz, as the Wonder Boys with an 11-0 lead are going to go to the pen in relief of Jack Rector, and they're going to bring in JT Cafferty. Cafferty is a right-handed pitcher, 6'3", 235 junior from the home of the Cornhuskers, Hastings, Nebraska. He'll come in now in relief of Jack Rector, who pitched really well. Rector went four innings, only gave up two hits, struck out four. Threw 47 pitches. So Cafferty will come on here with the Wonder Boys up 11-0, and he'll be facing the Tigers DH, Austin Wood, followed by Tanner Collins and Gage Boatman here as we play in the fifth inning. And the pitch, Cafferty misses for a ball. And the righty's 1-0. That bounces, two balls, no strikes. Here comes the 2-0. That is popped up on the infield. Cafferty goes back, but Dawson's going to come in, call everybody off, make the catch. And Wood is retired for the first out of the fifth. Coming into today, Cafferty has a 0.77 ERA. He's made nine appearances. He's gone 11 and two-thirds innings. Giving up nine hits, two runs, one of those earned. Six walks and 14 strikeouts, with opponents hitting 209 against. And his first pitch to Tanner Collins is down for a ball. So a really nice job by Jack Rector today. A nice, easy, pretty clean four innings. We got a stoppage in play here. Well, we got a ball loose on the field, or we got a panel of the backstop that came loose. And the official Tech baseball maintenance man completes the repairs, and we're ready to go again. And here comes the 1-0. That's in there for a strike. One ball, one strike. Here's the 1-1. That ball is hit really well to left field. Going back is Hogue at the wall. It's off the top of the wall. Hogue plays it on a bounce. His throw in made that way closer than I thought it was going to be, but Collins is safe at second, sliding in with a double. Hogue played that really well off the mini green monster out there in left field. Collins really gave that a ride. And Hogue's throw in was really well, but Collins slides in with a one-out double. And that'll bring in Gage Boatman now, the Tiger catcher. And Cafferty's pitch is in there for a called strike. No balls, one strike. Cafferty checks Collins over at second and comes home. That pitch just missed. One ball, one strike. The Wonder Boy faithful here at the Baz did not like that call. One ball, one strike. That pitch misses. Two balls, one strike now. One away here in the top of the fifth. Again, this is a seven-inning game here. Here's the pitch. It's fouled out of play over the right side. Two balls, two strikes. That pitch misses. The count runs full now. Ben Tate waiting on deck for the Tigers. That ball is lined into right field for a base hit. Collins had to hold at second to see if that was going to get through, so he only advances to third. But Boatman with a single here. And the Tigers now got runners at the corners with only one out. And Ben Tate making his way to the plate. Tate, if you'll remember. sixth hit batter of the day. As Driggers fires in a strike now to Brandon Button. Six batters hit by pitch today. And the pitch is lined well, fouled up down the third baseline. Button got all of that one, but he was way out in front. Hooked it foul. And here comes the pitch. That is hit well into left field. Going back is the left fielder. Allen just stands there. Get up, get back, and get out. Brandon Button. Absolute rocket. Smash to left field. The left fielder, Allen, just stood there, never even turned around. Brandon Button now makes it 13-1. Wonder Boys, what a shot. He got all of that. Here he comes to the dugout and celebrates with his teammates. A two-run blast by Brandon Button. Makes it 13-1. And that's going to bring up Logan Schwenke. Folks, Brandon Button got all of that. And the first pitch to Schwenke, misses for a ball. One-0 count on Logan Schwenke. That ball's popped up into right field, foul territory. The right fielder with a long run will not get there. Ball was hit pretty deep, but well, foul. One-one count now on Logan Schwenke. That pitch is in there for a called strike. One ball, two strike. Schwenke wearing the... No, he's not. He got hit by pitch in the first. He's been on base once, but he struck out three times today. That pitch is down. That brings the count two balls, two strikes. And the pitch is swung on and missed, and Schwenke goes down on strikes for the fourth time today. And that's going to bring up now Nick Jones with one away here.
Nick Jones.
First pitch to Jones is grounded over to short. Diving stop by Blankenship. Long throw to first. Not in time to get Jones. The ball got away from Whitaker, but the catcher, Boatman, backed it up. Jones is held to a single there. That's going to bring up Aaron Hose.
Now.
With one away here and Nick Jones over at first. Here comes the pitch. Hope fouls it back and out of play over the right side here. Pitch is grounded right back to the pitcher. Fields it, goes to first for one on, or goes to second for one and on to first, not in time. I think Tech may have an argument over there at second. I think that throw drew him off the bag over there, but nonetheless, there's two outs here. As Hogue now places Jones over at first base. That's going to bring up Keaton Rinaldo now. There's two away here now in the bottom of the sixth inning in a 13-1 Wonder Boy lead. Here's the pitch to Rinaldo. That's down and away, ball one. Rinaldo has homered and singled today. And here's the 1-0. That's outside, ball two. Two balls, no strikes. And here's the 2-0. That's inside. And Rinaldo's now ahead, three balls, no strikes. I doubt he's swinging here. And the 3-0 comes home. That gets away, but it doesn't matter. That's ball four. Folks, that's now, if I got it right, the 15th free pass of the day between being hit by a pitch and walks. Yeah, that's 15 free bases. Can't remember a game where six batters have been hit by a pitch in quite a while. So nine walks and six batters hit by a pitch.
I wonder with
and Wonder Boys are gonna have a pinch hitter here. Sawyer Duddleston is gonna pinch hit here now in the bottom of the sixth in place of Brendan Bard. And the first pitch to Duddleston's off the plate for a ball. I wonder what Mr. Statistician himself, Daniel, can tell me about the most times a Wonder Boy hitters have been hit by a pitch in a game. I'm digging through the record books and can't find that. And here's the 1-0 to Duddleston's, foul, backing out of play. Brings the count to one ball, one strike. I bet you he can find it, though. He is the holder of all things baseball statistics. Talk to me, Daniel. What do you got? Here's a 1-1 swing and a miss. Strike two. Sawyer Duddleston, the Springdale native, in a little pinch hit action here in the bottom of the sixth. And he waits on the 1-2. That's outside. Two balls, two strikes. Here comes the 2-2 to Duddleston. Outside, and the count runs full now. Full count, two outs. Runners will get a head start. Here it comes. That ball is smashed into left center field, and that's down for a base hit. Into score is Hogue. Over to third goes Rinaldo and Sawyer Duddleston with an RBI single. That a kid there, 18. Way to go, Sue. And it's now 14-1, Wonder Boys. Duddleston got a hold of that one. put it into left center field. And that's probably going to be it for Mr. Driggers here. With the Wonder Boys, runners on the corners. 3 runs home this inning on their 12th base hit. And they lead this game 14-1. I think that's now 35-4 in this series. And there's a little meeting on the mound, but that was a quick one. It's over. Looks like they're going to stick with Driggers here. And that'll bring up Shane Poe now for the Wonder Boys. Poe will bat with runners in the corners now.
Second baseman, number one, Shane Poe.
Poe today is has a sac fly, a single, and a couple of flyouts. And the first pitch to him misses high for a ball. 1 ball, no strikes. And the pitch to Poe, high, ball two. Looks like the Wonder Boys are going to go with Tyler Sardelli. He's got a bat on the on-deck circle. So if Mr. Poe can reach, Mr. Sardelli will get in that bat. Here's the pitch. That ball is lined in the left center field, and that's going to get down into the gap. That's going to roll to the wall. In comes Rinaldo, rounding third and heading for home is Dunstan. The throw in is not in time, and it is 16-1. On the RBI double, two RBI double from Shane Poe. And the Wonder Boys are absolutely pouring it on, folks. 16-1 here in the bottom of the sixth inning.
And that
will bring up Tyler Sardelli, the sophomore out of Olathe, Kansas, and he'll get in at bat here with Poe over at second. And the first pitch to him is in there for a strike. The Wonder Boys with 5 in the first, 3 in the second and the third, and now 6 more here in the fifth, or excuse me, 5 more here in the sixth. And the pitch to Sardelli. Sardelli pops it up out of play over the third base side. And he's in the hole. No balls, 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. That's down. One ball, 2 strikes now. Here comes the 1-2. That's off the plate. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Comes the 2-2. That ball's hammered into right center field. That's hit pretty well. Going back, and that's going to get down and all the way to the wall. Played on a hop by the right fielder, Tate. In to score is Poe, and cruising into second base with a 2-out double is Tyler Sardelli, and it's now 17-1. Runs on 14 base hits. By the Wonder Boys, and out to the mound comes the Tiger skipper. And that's going to be it for Mr. Driggers. The Wonder Boys have hammered the Tigers here. It is 17-1 with two outs here in the bottom of the sixth. We'll be right back to tell you about the new Tiger Hurler here in just a minute.
Attention, please, fans. Pitching change for East Central. We have now number 32, Micah Five.
And we're back here at Baswell Field. The Wonder Boys batting in the bottom of the sixth with a 17-1 lead. And the Tigers are going back to the bullpen. And they're going to go to the right-hander, Micah Cloud. Cloud is a 6-foot junior out of Dewar, Oklahoma, via Mid-America Christian. He's going to come on here with two outs in the bottom of the sixth. Trying to see, it looks like we're going back to the top of the Wonder Boy order, but it looks like we may have a pinch hitter here. I'm trying to get some information on Cloud. Cloud comes into today with a 10.13 ERA. He's only made five appearances. He's only pitched 5 1/3 innings. He's given up 11 hits and 10 runs, six of those earned. He's walked 9. And he's struck out 7. Opponents are hitting .407 so far, a small sample size. So standing over at second base is Tyler Sardelli. And the wheels are a-turning here at Baswell Field for the Wonder Boys. 5 runs in the first, 3 in the second, 3 in the third, and 6 now here in the bottom of the sixth. And it does indeed look like we're going to have a pinch hitter here as Coach Dawson getting some folks some at-bats. Looks like from here Nolan Self is going to pinch hit here now for Cabranes. And he'll stroll up to the plate here with two outs. Again, Nolan Self out of Sykeston, Missouri. Cloud's ready to go. Self's in the box, and here we go. First pitch misses high. 1 ball, no strikes. And Cloud's ready with the 1-0. Here it comes. That's off the plate. 2 balls, no strikes. Self comes into today hitting .500. He's only had 4 official at-bats before today. And the next pitch misses. Self thought about swinging, but he checked it. He's ahead 3 balls, no strikes now, with Brandon Button waiting on deck. The junior out of Sykeston in Three Rivers Community College. Takes the 3-0 for a strike. Everybody's having fun today. When it's 17-1 on a beautiful day at the ballpark, what more can you ask? And that misses. And Self's aboard now with a two-out walk. And the Wonder Boys have batted around again here. They batted around in the first, and now here again in the sixth as Brandon Button strolls to the plate. Button, if you'll recall, hit a home run earlier this inning. And he takes the first pitch from Micah Cloud for a strike. No balls, one strike here to Brandon Button with Logan Schwenke waiting on deck. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Button now in the hole. No balls, two strikes. Here comes the 0-2. Downstairs for a ball. One ball, two strikes. And Cloud's ready. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Foul tip. Actually, Button goes down on strikes. And that'll do it for the Wonder Boys here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Folks, it's closing time. Time to break out the brooms here. We're headed to the top of the seventh inning with your Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys leading East Central Oklahoma 17-1. And we're back here for the top of the seventh here. It is closing time here at Baswell Field as the Wonder Boys have gone to the pen and they've called on the right hander, Mason Griffin. Griffin comes into today with a one-loss record of 1-1, an ERA of 4.24. He's made 13 appearances so far with two starts. He's gone 17 innings, giving up 13 hits, 8 runs, all 8 of them earned. Walked 9, struck out 28, and opponents are hitting 206 against. And he'll be called on here to shut things down and close out a Wonder Boy sweep. And he'll be set to face the bottom third of the Tiger order here and Boatman, Tate, and Sperry. There's a host of defensive changes here. Wonder Boys have got Nolan Self behind the plate. We've got Leo Minato over at second. Luke Ray at third. I'll try to get you caught up on all the changes here in just a second. As Griffin goes to work. First pitch is high and inside for a ball. Pitch is chopped over the mound and into center field for a base hit. So Boatman is aboard with a leadoff single here. And that'll bring in Ben Tate now. We need to add to Daniel's to-do list. Besides obvious priority track, man, I need binoculars. That first pitch to Tate is fouled back and out of play. I need Daniel to go shopping for me. Not asking for a whole lot. Well, maybe I am. No balls, one strike on Ben Tate here. So one misses, one ball, one strike now. Wonder Boys looking to sweep the Tigers out of town. Here's the pitch. Line right back at Griffin. Fielded there at second. For one, over to first. That's a Wonder Boy twin killing, and now there's two gone. Very nicely done by the Wonder Boys there. And so the Tigers are down to their last out. And then bring in Britton Sperry now. Folks, just so happens that I can see the East Central Oklahoma bus out there beyond right field. I wonder if they're warming it up. First pitch is grounded sharply to short. Fielded clean, throw across in time, and that's going to do it. Break out the brooms, folks. The Wonder Boys have swept the Tigers. Your final here in game number three, Arkansas Tech 17. East Central Oklahoma won.
Final score in game two of our doubleheader. Arkansas Tech wins it 17-1 over East Central. Fans, we thank you for coming out to the ballpark this weekend and enjoying some Wonder Boys baseball. We invite you back here this coming Tuesday, April 16th. Wonder Boys will be at home against Central Oklahoma. That game is scheduled to start at 3 o'clock p.m. Once again, Wonder Boys back in town, Tuesday, April 16th, against Central Oklahoma, for pitch 3 p.m.